Hello, Steve Roach here at CRMCulture, bringing you a demonstration of the Pivotal 6.0 hypernavigation. This demonstration will once again show how Pivotal puts the R back into CRM as we simply and elegantly navigate the relationships of the data defined in the CRM. We can unabashedly say that no other CRM system on the market can navigate and transform the data in your system as easily as we are about to show. Hypernavigation lets us access complex data without writing queries. Of course, Pivotal and all other CRMs have robust query engines, but most users have difficulty understanding relational databases and sometimes have difficulties, no matter how good the query engines are, at getting at that data. You can convert any list of one data type, so a list of companies, say, and turn that into all of the child contacts underneath all of those companies with a single click of the mouse. We do this by reading the Pivotal Business Module defined in the toolkit and how all the tables are hooked together dynamically to navigate the database and bring up any navigation that you want to define. It is all working for custom tables because it is dynamically reading the Pivotal data structure. And it's simple to configure. There's no coding, and at the end of the demo, we'll show you how to configure it all right within the system. So let's demonstrate hypernavigation. What we're going to do is a typical day in the life of a user or maybe a marketing person who wants to query some data. And let's just say that we run some sort of a simple query of my companies. And I want to work with my companies, but really what I want to do is work with the context underneath there and turn that into some kind of actionable item, such as an email to all of them or something like this. So often you have to write a query to do that and navigate down from the company to the many contacts and so forth. What we're going to do is just cherry pick a few of these companies just to make it a little bit easier. So we've got four companies here, and we're going to expose the hypernavigation with a right click to any data grid. Anytime we see a grid that looks like Excel, we can show the hypernavigation right here. What we're going to do is that's going to expose a menu of different things that we've chosen via configuration to let users of the security group I'm currently in to see. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the related contacts, and that's going to show us all of the contacts under those four companies. As we do that, we can drill down into there and see that we've got company 1, 2, 3, and 4, the four companies that I had chosen. Those are the contacts underneath of those four companies. I can further navigate to that data by selecting all of this. Let's say I had a list of contacts and I needed to see just the companies. I can also do distinct companies, again, just defined in the data. Now, it's not just restricted to the grids, as we see. We can drill down into a company record. And when we're on a company record, we might see, or a contact, it doesn't really matter where we are, but anytime you see a grid of data, you can navigate down further into it. So in this case, I see a grid of order data, but it's a high level, and I want to see the products that were actually ordered of these four orders. So again, I can hyper-navigate, display a list, and see the related orders underneath there. Sorry, my WebEx screen was in the way. Let me do that again. I'm going to show the related products of those orders. And so that's the four orders that were made, and these are the line items of those four orders. So it's quite easy to navigate any of that data. Now let's just look at how that data is defined. How those relationships are defined. It's all done with this productivity pack settings. And what you see here is all of the table of tables the structure of the pivotal system is exposed to us right here in the interface. They're easy to get to. And typically these would be done by an administrator. These settings are done by an administrator, but you'll see there's no coding involved. And what we've got here is it looks like we've got several relationships, and we're looking at the kind of features here. There's some other productivity pack features defined, but we're concentrating on these child lists and parent lists. So what we can see is the way that we got access to the orders and the opportunities is because we're in the sales user group, and we could distinct the contacts or show the many contacts underneath there by this relationship here. Now, if I wanted to, I see I don't have quotes defined, so I think I'll add a new relationship of companies and the many quotations or proposals that are underneath those. So I'm going to define a child relationship. So I'm going to navigate from the company to a child set of data. I'm going to let this only be defined for people in the sales user security group. And this table here is now showing me the secondary tables. These are only tables that are have many records underneath the company. So it's restricted that and filtered that for us. And then lastly, it's going to ask us how that data is hooked together. On the quote table, there is a company ID. So I'll save that. And now we can come back here to our companies again. And now we should see our hyper-navigation exposes the quotes table, all without coding. Anywhere that that appears, as long as you're in those security groups, you can navigate to that data. So hopefully what we've demonstrated here is how we can easily transform data into actionable items, such as doing an email list or something like that, to people, all with just simple right-clicking without ever writing any queries. Thanks.